The Quaker Graveyard in Nantucket by Robert Lowell. Let man have dominion over the fishes of the sea, and the fowls of the air, and the beasts, and the whole earth, and every creeping creature that moveth upon the earth. A brackish reach of shoal off Madiket. The sea was breaking violently in night, had steamed into our North Atlantic fleet, when the drowned sailor clutched the dragnet, light flashed from his matted head and marble feet. He grappled at the net with the coiled, hurtling muscles of his thighs. The corpse was bloodless, a botch of reds and whites. Its open, staring eyes were lustreless dead lights, or cabin windows on a stranded hulk, heavy with sand. We wait the body, close its eyes, and heave it seaward whence it came. Where the heel-headed dogfish barks at its nose on Ahab's void and forehead, and the name is blocked in yellow chalk. Sailors who pitch this portent at the sea, where dreadnoughts shall confess its hell-bent deity, when you are powerless to sandbag this Atlantic bulwark faced by the earth-shaker, green, unwearied, chaste in his steel scales, ask for no Orphean loot to pluck life back. The guns of the steel fleet recoil and then repeat the hoarse salute. Whenever winds are moving and their breath heaves at the roped-in bulwarks of this pier, the terns and seagulls tremble at your death in these home waters. O sailor, can you hear the Pequod's sea-wings beating landward fall headlong and break on our Atlantic wall? Off Sconset, where the yawing S-boats splash, the bellboy with ballooning spinnakers and the entangled screeching mainsheet clears the blocks off Madiket, where lubbers lash the heavy surf and throw their long lead squids for bluefish. Seagulls blink their heavy lids seaward. The wind's wings beat upon the stones, cousin, and scream for you, and the claws rush at the sea's throat and wring it in the slush of this old Quaker graveyard, where the bones cry out in the long night for the hurt beast bobbing by Ahab's whaleboats in the east. All you recovered from Poseidon died with you, my cousin, and the harrowed brine is fruitless on the blue beard of the god, stretching before us to the castles in Spain, Nantucket's westward haven. To Cape Cod, guns cradled on the tide, blast the eelgrass about a water-clock of bilge and backwash, roil the salt and sand, lashing earth's scaffold, rock thou worships in the hand of the great god, where time's contrition blues, whatever it was, these Quaker sailors lost in the mad scramble of their lives. They died when time was open-eyed, wooden and childish. Only bones abide there in the nowhere, where their boats were tossed sky-high, where mariners had fable news of Is, the whited monster. What it cost them is their secret. In the sperm whale's slick I see the Quakers drown, and hear their cry. If God himself had not been by our side, if God himself had not been on our side, when the Atlantic rose against us, why, then it had swallowed us up quick. This is the end of the whale road and the whale, who spewed Nantucket bones on the thrash swell, and stirred the troubled waters to whirlpools, to send the Pequod packing off to hell. This is the end of them, three-quarters fools, snatching at straws to sail seaward and seaward on the turntail whale, spouting out blood and water as it rolls, sick as a dog, to these Atlantic shoals. Clamavimus, so depths, let seagulls wail for water, for the deep where the high tide mutters to its hurt self, mutters and ebbs. Waves wallow in their wash, go out and out, leave only the death rattle of the crabs, the beach increasing, its enormous snout sucking the ocean's side. This is the end of running on the waves. We are poured out like water. Who will dance the mast-lashed master of leviathans up from this field of Quakers in their unstoned graves? When the whale's viscera go and the roll of its corruption overruns the world, beyond tree-swept Nantucket and Woods Hole and Martha's Vineyard, sailor, will your sword whistle and fall and sink into the fat? In the great ash pit of Jehoshaphat, the bones cry for the blood of the white whale. The fat flukes arch and whack about its ears. The death lance churns into the sanctuary, tears the gun-blue swingle, heaving like a flail, and hanks the coiling life out. It works and drags and rips the sperm whale's midriff into rags. Gobbets of blubber spill to wind and weather. Sailor and gulls go round the stoven timbers, where the morning stars sing out together, and the thunder shakes the white surf and dismembers the red flag hammered to the masthead. Hide our steel, Jonas Messias, in thy side. Our Lady of Walsingham. There once the penitents took off their shoes, and then walked barefoot the remaining mile, and the small trees, a stream and hedgerows file slowly along the munching English lane, like cows to the old shrine, until you lose track of your dragging pain. The stream flows down under the druid tree, Shiloah's whirlpools gurgle and make glad the castle of God. Sailor, you are glad and whistled Sion by that stream, but see, Our Lady, too small for her canopy, sits near the altar. There's no comeliness at all, or charm in that expressionless face with its heavy eyelids. As before, this face, for centuries a memory, non est species, neque decor, expressionless, expresses God. It goes past Castle Sion. She knows what God knows. Not Calvary's cross, nor crib at Bethlehem. Now, and the world shall come to Walsingham. The empty winds are creaking, and the oak splatters and splatters on the cenotaph. The boughs are trembling, and a gaff bobs on the untimely stroke of the greased wash exploding on a shoal bell in the old mouth of the Atlantic. It's well, Atlantic. You are fouled with the blue sailors, sea monsters, upward angel, downward fish, unmarried and corroding, spare of flesh, mart once of supercilious winged clippers, Atlantic, where your bell trap guts its spoil. You could cut the brackish winds with a knife here in Nantucket and cast up the time when the Lord God formed man from the sea's slime and breathed into his face the breath of life. And the blue-lunged comas lumbered to the kill. The Lord survives the rainbow of his will.